Well, Dad, I was so sad to hear Mr. Melnick passed away.
Eugene, and, yeah.
Yeah, I was, you know what? He sure liked you.
Well, I think he liked me was because the hypocrisy, isn't that a word? I've learned that
That's
word.
A good word, Dad.
I had to really, hypocrisy of the left-wing media is unbelievable. And Ottawa, especially Ottawa, all he did was give him heck the whole time he was there. And
which is sort of like, I don't get it. Like, they only had a team because of him, constantly losing money, and he stayed, and yet he still was, you know, they criticized him.
It was down by, I remember the interview he had. Well, there was about six reporters around him, and what he said was, he's so right, and I said it in Hockey Night in Canada, if the fans aren't going to come out, why stay there? And boy, did he get reamed for that one.
Yeah, and you know, I think, you know, kind of knocking Ottawa a little bit here, but remember, they were in the semifinals, game six. If they win, they're in the finals. They're playing Pittsburgh with Crosby. And they didn't sell out.
So you're, you know, I really don't, and maybe I'm stepping out of line here, but I don't believe that Ottawa is a hockey city or... Yeah.
And you know, Melnick, like... You know, you and I have talked about it. He's kind of like Jerry Jones in a way, where he's the face of the franchise, yeah. Whereas the Leafs are kind of a faceless corporation.
Remember, they had signs,
and the media just would go after him.
Yeah, and remember, they had signs. Remember, he had a picture of a sign.
He called me. I'll tell you, he called me when you got fired from Sportsnet, whatever you call it. And he's really a great guy.
He,
you know, we talked like 30-40 minutes. We fed off of each other, and I was a really interesting.
A great guy.
And what I want to say about Mr. Melnick is that he was criticized by a lot of people, and even it was in the paper, about that he jumped the queue when he got his liver transplant. And I know for a fact, because, you know, I'm heavily into kidney, you know, and organ
transplants,
donation. Yeah, organ donation in Canada. And I have a friend that she had a kidney transplant, and she had a doctor of his. And I just want to say he didn't jump the queue like he was accused of.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. It was, you know, oh, you know, he paid for his liver transplant. And he really, afterwards, it was very successful. And he was very into promoting organ transplant in Canada, because you know how dismal Canada is for organ transplant. So I just want to say to all the people that question it or say that he did not jump the queue, he played by the rules. He played by the rules, and it was a success.
I should tell you the story. I tell you one story that I thought was funny. Well, I don't. He phoned me up, and he was talking to me. He said, "Who do you who long time ago? Who do you want to trade? Do you want to trade Redden, or who would you trade, Redden or Chara?" I said, "What is this, a joke?" And he said, "No." He says, "We're, you know." So I think the powers to be, they chose Redden.
Well, you said, "What are you, nuts?"
He said, "You're nuts?
What are you, nuts?" He said, "Chara's going to be a force for 10 years. Well.
And what he is, he's 20 years.
Yeah, he's still going.
But anyhow, you know, it's a funny thing. This Christmas, I got, I said, "Who's this from?" And my wife said, "It's from Eugene Melnick." We took that candle when we found out that that he had died, and we lit that candle.